sorted out over recent months. And clearly in the case of Cardiff West, we won a very important by-election in Ely last week, and you know, who'd have thought that Plaid Cymru would be winning in Ely?
Okay, let's talk about Wednesday and Brexit. Anne McMorrin, just now we were discussing the possibilities, the sort of things that might happen. Do you see this as one of the votes that could change the direction? But you do?
Absolutely do. We need
in
to,
what way?
We need to get no deal off the table. We know that no deal is going to be the worst of all options.
And how are you going to do that with the Cooper-Letwin amendment?
The Cooper-Letwin amendment, by backing that, and we know that there's support across the House, a good number of, we're supporting it as a party, Labour Party supporting it, there's a good number of Tory MPs who are going to support it, as well as other parties. So if we get that through, that then takes us to pushing through legislation that will take no deal off the table, with just days to go now before pushing
that brings me to questions about Labour's position, because it seems, I mean, we're still trying to work out exactly what Labour's new position is, but it does seem to be, from what Emily Thornberry was saying earlier on, that there won't be any amendment this week that'll actually put the new position. You'll want to see the get no deal off the table, see if you can get another go at getting Labour's position. Why don't you move quickly, more quickly? As you say, there's only days
to
go.
Look, I really welcome what Jeremy has said tonight, what Keir said tonight at the PLP. They both were there talking about supporting the public vote. Now,
But they could do it more quickly. They could do it Wednesday.
Look, you know that we've been talking about this for months. I've supported a public vote for months. Now, I'd like to see that quickly, but I'm really pleased that we are where we are now.
Jonathan Edwards, Labour's new position must be something that pleases you, but do you agree that it should be done more quickly?
Yeah, I think we've been going around in circles really since November, because the political parties, especially the British government, hasn't developed this policy, despite the deal being defeated by over 200 votes. The Labour Party haven't really developed their policy after they lost that vote of no confidence. So I think tonight is pretty significant.
It is.
If the Labour Party's position is that they want to remain on the ballot paper, and I think that is the position that the Shadow Foreign Secretary is outlined, but that's not come from the leadership yet.
No.
That's absolutely vital. But the key thing then, of course, in politics is a numbers game. When it comes to the vote, can the Labour Party deliver a full house? Because we know there's 43 Labour MPs who said they would not support a motion or an amendment calling for a second referendum. And if those numbers don't fall, the vote will fall here and Theresa May wins. That's the reality.
Is Parliament being played? Is Theresa May winding down the clock to make her deal on
it? It certainly seems that way. You know, she's pushed another meaningful vote this week to 2 weeks' time. That is literally days. Now, we know that we've got shipments coming over. They don't know the situation after March the 29th.
Jonathan Edwards, do you think Parliament's been played or forced into?
Well, I think both parties have been running down the clock. And, you know, I'm a very cynical person here after nearly a decade down here in London.
Surely not.
I can see the Chief Whip of the government, Julian Smith, and Nick Brown, the Chief Whip of the Labour Party, they're in there crunching numbers now to make sure there'll be enough Labour rebels to defeat the referendum.
That's why Nick Brown wasn't in my report then, clearly. There we go. Thank you very much.
We'll
find out exactly what happens soon enough.
We will.
Anna McMorrin and Jonathan Edwards, much appreciated. Away from Westminster, there's been a special sitting in the Assembly.